So he was a man of the word and a man of the spirit.
Yeah.
Bible school is crucial. Now, somebody called me some time ago. I was on TV and they said, what are you talking about? Acts 4:13, we are told that the disciples, you know, after they healed a lame man and they had a problem with the Sanhedrin, they wanted to put him through in prison and everything. The people, the Jewish priests said, made a remark that they realized that these people were uneducated and untrained, but they realized they had been with Jesus. So by that English word, uneducated, they just argue that then you don't need good Bible school. But they don't understand. Because the Greek, the word uneducated, you know, agrammatoi, you know, that prefix a is a negation in Greek. Not educated means that they had not been schooled in the official theological schools of the day. There were two of them, the school of Shammai and the school of Hillel. Now, most of the rabbis went to that school. Just a bit like saying, if you've not been to Oxford or Cambridge, it means you've not been to school. That is the perspective then.
Yes.
So they were saying that these people had not been, they were surprised because they had not been to the official theological schools of the day, which even Jesus condemned, because those schools were schools devoid of the spirit. Mm. It was just an intellectual exercise, but there was no life in it.
Yes.
So he said they had not been educated, they were not uneducated or untrained. Mm. The Greek word is idiotai, where we had the English word idiot.
Yes.
You know, simply just meaning that they were laymen. Mm. You see, but don't forget that these disciples had the opportunity to be in the best Bible school you could ever attend.
Yes.
Jesus was the professor himself.
Oh, of course.
For 3 years. Yes. That's a bachelor's
degree. 3.5 years.
Absolutely. That's equivalent to a BA in theology.
That's very true.
So they were trained.
Oh, gosh.
And then and when Jesus left, they wrote theology.
Yes.
All the theology we have in the John and the other epistles, the Petrine authorship of like 1 Peter, 2 Peter, and all that. These were the guys. These were the fishermen. They've come a long way.
Yes.
They've been schooled in Jesus' Bible school.
Yes.
You come to Mark 6:30 and we are told that there were times they went to do miracles and they came and they reported Jesus all that he had taught. And said, you come aside and rest a while. That's the time he taught them.
Yes.
There were breaks he had to spend with the disciples. You see, he went to the field and the evangelistic anointing crowds, but he spent his time with the disciples.
Yes.
Look at Matthew 13, the parable of the sower. The Bible says that to those who are outside, everything was in parables, but to them, when he came aside, he interpreted.
Yes.
So teaching was going on all the time.
If you
look at Jesus' ministry, I would say about 70% of his ministry was teaching.
Oh, yes.
Matthew 4:23. Jesus went about all the place, Galilee, all the place, teaching in the synagogues.
Yes.
You know, so we need a Bible school. We need training.
Yes.
We need equipping. For instance, the Holy Spirit won't teach you Greek in your bedroom, but you come to Bible school. And through us, the Spirit will, through some of us who have been enlightened and educated in seminaries, will teach you Greek.
Yes.
You know, so it's so important. They need to come. I'm calling every pastor out there to come forth.
Amen. That's good. I'm glad you did that. And by the way, we only have maybe seven.
All right.
And we got 2 minutes left? My clock must be slow. I was going to open the phone line and allow people to ask questions, but apparently we've only got 2 minutes. Goodness me.
Yeah.
So let me ask you this. Pastor Moses, you've come out of the Bible school.
Yeah.
Are you now affiliated with the Bible school? In what way do you teach?
Well, I teach in the Bible school.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I teach church history,
yes.
Old Testament survey, New Testament survey, and systematic theology as well.
That's great. So you got the whole package here. And of course, Dr. Richard has moved you into your calling as well.
He's already an academic person. Yeah, he had his Master of Philosophy already. And education administration before he came to his master's in Bible and theology, and he's now registered for the PhD.
Yes.
You know, he's starting next week with a doctorate.
Amen.
You know, he's a very sound, sound man. I'm happy to have him on board.
Yeah.
You know, a man of integrity, you know, and sound.
Well, Dr. Richard, look, we're in our last couple of minutes here. So do you have a word on your belly right now? If there's a word in there, let it out right now.
Yeah, what I'm going to say to viewers is this,
yes.
that, you know, we live in a harsh economic climate, and,
yes.
you know, but God is saying to them that, you know, it is about time that we came closer to him.
Yes.
And also, God wants to use many of us viewers, but he is not able to.
Yes.
In Psalm 74:21, the Bible says concerning Israelites, it said they limited the Holy One. God wants to do something, but we need to prepare.
Amen.
We need to be prepared. We need to be trained.
Amen.
So he can commission us
Amen.
And use us for
well,
for
well there you have it. You need to be prepared. You've heard it tonight. Next Monday night, we've got 5 seconds, so that's the end of the program. But next Monday night, come to Rama Bible College and get enrolled.